Scooby-Dee, my friends! You're watching the thrift store rundown, bringing Hollywood home on a budget! Welcome to a place I like to call Foodie Road, Washington Street, here in Paterson. Food, food, food aplenty here on this street. For today's Thanksgiving Eve video, I thought we'd take a little trip to George the Butcher, where my parents go to get all their meat. An ideal place to be shooting today's review. Meat! Everything you need to know by America's most celebrated butcher, Pat LaFrieda. It's a critically acclaimed book, drawing rave reviews from Martha Stewart, Mario Batali, Rachel Ray, Seth Alex Gonzalez, and Jeffrey Zacharian. This town does not appreciate a good Hollywood bargain hunter.
Hello.
Which is why I still continue to do this. I don't know if this place sells the kind of meats so vividly described in this book. But what I do know is that this town is semi-peaceful, and the owners know my parents, so they shouldn't have much of a problem with me filming inside their place. But before we get to them, let's talk about LaFrieda meat.
I often say, I do all my best thinking when I'm in that solitude of just the meat and myself. It's the calmest I'm ever during the day. It's just very special and dear to me. The one thing my father never wanted me to be was a butcher. So my dad used to take me to work with him at 3 a.m. in the cold, make me work those grueling hours, but it backfired on him. I graduated college with a finance degree. I immediately got a job on Wall Street. I was going to work in a suit, had a briefcase, and I hated it. The only thing that ever made sense to me was working with my dad in the family business and make LaFrieda Meats the biggest and best butcher company in the United States. This was my destiny. What we did differently is what set us apart and what made us survive. My grandfather always told me, you cannot hide your sins in the chop beef machine. He only used the best stuff. Cuts of meat that butchers would never even conceive of grinding. When you put that much thought into what goes into the burger, you want to keep it as simple as possible. American cheese, sweet pickles because they're my dad's favorite, on a potato bun, that's a butcher's burger. Throughout all of our successes, there's never been that high five moment between my dad and I. My dad, he's old school. I know, I see that glimmer in his eye, and secretly, I know he's proud.
All right, guys, let's meet the meat. This is their super family plan number 11, whatever that is. 4 pounds of turkey wings, pig feet, neck bones, chicken rings, 5 pounds chicken legs, 3 pounds smoked neck bones, fresh ground beef, stew beef, which is generally never a good thing to buy for beef stew. Cut your own stew meat, never buy it from the butcher. It's more expensive and less quality. California steak, cube steak, lean cut pork chops, smoked ham slices, and a bag of hot dogs. For $104.99. But 2 packages of bacon for free. Oxtail, ground beef, cube steak, California steak, beef bologna, smoked beef sausage, ground beef pepper steak, beef kielbasa, beef stew with bone, again, stay away. Chicken, beef, the usual suspects of meat, except seafood. Seafood channels, right over here in this area, they have fishmongers on duty. This is just a small sampling of what they have inside. Before we go inside, let's go over to Pat LaFrieda of LaFrieda Meats again.
Willie, I got an order. We need 6 179s for quality, 18 ounces.
Okay. I'm often asked what I do for a living, and I tell people I'm a meat purveyor, and they usually have no idea what I'm talking about.
I butcher meat and supply over 600 restaurants a day.
We need two 109s for post house, 28 to 30 pounds.
The best way to cut meat and to supply restaurants is to do it every night fresh by hand. It's the way my grandfather used to do it, and it's the way we still do it today.
My dad taught me everything I know about being a butcher.
Well, I come from a long list of family members that are all in the meat business, going back to a great-grandfather, grandfather, and all my uncles. We think being a meat man is it.
My great-grandfather was in Naples, and he got into a fight outside a butcher shop.
He got punched in the eye, and his eyes all black and blue. And this man came out, and he said, come on into the shop. He said, let me put a steak on your eye, and we'll get the swelling down.
The butchers took him in, and they said, you know what? You may have lost the fight today, but you got yourself a job.
And you come here, and I'm going to teach you how to be a butcher, and you're going to learn the trade. And that's how it started.
Let's eat the meat.
Faux
veal this time. Little empty today. Perhaps Thanksgiving Eve and they need a little more meat. Did you know that nearly 90% of the American population eats some sort of bird on Thanksgiving? That's according to the National Turkey Federation. So beef bologna, sauce meat, liver pudding, liverwurst, all meat bologna, spiced ham, ham pastrami, turkey pastrami. If you're looking for something deliciously different, that's $5.49. Barbecue sauce. Yes, this place even sells barbecue sauce. And Heinz ketchup, my favorite ketchup. There is no other substitute. Was a fraction of what George the Butcher sells every single day here. They even do specialty cuts, I think. But I don't think they compare to what LaFrieda and company has as their meat market. I'm not saying this to be blasphemous to George the Butcher. I love to support small local businesses, but hey, it's true. And if you don't believe me, take a look.
My grandfather and his older brother started LaFrieda Meats back in 1922 in Manhattan. At Pat LaFrieda Meats, we produce every kind of meat that there is. We are meat specialists, so that's all we do is produce meat. So we have beef, lamb, pork, wild game, and we happen to be standing in the dry age room, which is all beef. Every week we sell about 200,000 to 300,000 pounds of beef. What makes a great steak is marbleization. We're talking about the intramuscular fat inside the eye of the steak. So if you take some great quality American beef, dry age it for about 5 to 6 weeks, there's nothing better. Our most expensive beef, which is Kobe, is about $26 a pound. The latest trend in beef production actually is dry aged beef. The room that we're standing in right now, that's what everyone's been asking us for. And not necessarily in Kobe, in high choice and in prime. That's what the trend is, and I think it kind of dipped a little bit, and now it's back in. Everybody wants dry-aged beef. All of our products are sustainable. A lot of them are all natural, and some of them organic. It really depends on the price structure. Not every restaurant can afford to put organic meat on the menu, and I think that the organic movement has kind of peaked, and now we see more of an all-natural, never-ever program that's emerging. That's the trend. The trend is products that have never had any antibiotics or growth hormones added to it. 2 years ago, we invested all of our life savings into building a new facility. So we were in Manhattan since 1922, and we just simply ran out of room. So we wanted to build a USDA facility here in New Jersey, which is only a mile and a half from the center of Manhattan. We made my father the general contractor. He was the GC of the building. So he built this from the ground up from materials that were as green as possible. So even the cinder block that the outside of the building is built with has insulation which zigzags through it. We have everything from infrared lights in this room so that when the fluorescent lights go off, the infrared lights come on and kill bacteria in the room. It's all those types of innovations and thought that went into building this building. We serve about 1,000 restaurants now every day. So we have 1,000 restaurants with 1,000 different chefs calling in with a lot of different ideas and requests. And to fulfill every one every day is very challenging. Recently, we just filmed a reality-based television show based on our company and the interactions between my father, my cousin, and myself. And it's a little bit of a look into the behind the scenes of how restaurants get supplied meat, where meat comes from, how it's produced, how it's cut, and actually the struggle of getting it to a restaurant 6 days a week. To be in the food world in New York City is very tough. So our restaurants and chefs, they demand the best service, the best product, and they don't want anything else. I mean, they don't want to hear anything else. And our culture and our family culture has always been that we've been raised to be those behind the scenes people.
This encyclopedia of meat was purchased for $9.99 and bought for 50% off. So, $4.99. Retail price, $39.99 US, $47.99 in Canada. And let me tell you, this is truly an encyclopedia of meat. Every kind of usual suspect cut of meat there is detailed and illustrated in the book, how to prepare it, how to clean it, how to cook it properly. From those usual suspect cuts, chicken, pork, and beef, to other odd cuts, like ox tails and quail, those odd cuts are also examined in this book. Plus, it's also a cookbook with a lot of recipes. From burger blends, to making your own sausage, to your own tomato sauce, lots of recipes in here, which also makes this book a winner. With the exception of seafood, I've yet to find another meat book that's as thorough and lavishly illustrated and photographed as Meat by Pat LaFrieda. Plus, the reason why this is in my library is because Pat LaFrieda and company had their own reality show on the Food Network, produced by the fine company at 0.0 Productions, the guys who made the Emmy award-winning Anthony Bourdain, No Reservations, The Mind of a Chef. It's called Meat Men, ran for 6 episodes, short-lived. Plus, LaFrieda Meats, traffic in this town sucks. LaFrieda Meats developed the original New York State sandwich for Citi Field, home of the New York Mets. That is a crowd-pleasing attraction I don't think the Mets can even compare to. When I say every odd cut of meat, I mean it. There's grilled calf's tongue. Yes, they do focus on lamb. It's very windy out here. Hey, doing it the day before Thanksgiving is better than doing it the day of. This place might be closed. They even have a recipe for whipped calf's brain puree. Calf's brain. Now that is a real butcher. That's the one that's going to be on Peter's most wanted list. Or unwanted list. Whatever. The point is, this is as thorough of a beat book as it's ever gonna get. This is a town that does not like to be in the spotlight for any reason. At the top of the show, some of the fishmongers from Washington Fish came by and told me to film from the side instead of obscuring their view here at the front for potential customers. That's fine. And then you got traffic here, horns honking every which way but right. But all that is worth it. Plus, George the Butcher was pretty crowded in there compared to other days. Hey, it's the day before Thanksgiving. So a few of the butchers said, today was not a good day to do this. Why don't you come back a little later when things settle down? Well, I am very impatient. But all that is worth it. Bravery will be rewarded. Fear will either be met with silence or terrible punishment. And in the end, all of those brave pigs and chickens and cows and lambs and sheep and other types of animals were brave enough to sacrifice their lives so that we, the people, may have a proper meal on our hands. And most of all, I want to salute all the turkeys who gave their lives in a line of meat duty. Thank you for watching the Thrift Store Rundown, where we bring Hollywood home on a budget. I hope all of you have a wonderful Thanksgiving. And if you happen to see Pat LaFrieda, tell him that I sent you to him, okay? To the Thrift Store Rundown.